listen to Savannah Brown slam words down about rape and blithe bards speak about how eating just wasn't an option, I was often more moved by how they spoke it, not how they wrote it. So I wish for my delivery to capture your attention, for it to reach inside your mind and twist the direction of your comprehension. Yet sometimes I write these poems for myself as much as for anyone else. I use them to straighten out my lines of thought and to untangle the knots. Sometimes poetry becomes my meditation, because I don't need medication. I have my God, I have writing, and I have breath. And sometimes I use these not quite rhymes to try and find someone who has a similar mind. Not that I'm wishing my own struggles upon another, but I'm wishing to find someone to recover with, a friend to hold my hand and rejoice as self-love becomes a sermon I preach, as I no longer give the old self-hate speech. I want you to see what I speak. I want your eyes to be opened. This is the why I wrote this poem. I want you to smile when it's over, because some words might be grim, but it's just a mental gym. It makes your mind work to the time of my speaking. So you smile when you understand what I'm thinking, and you like the way I say my words with just the right inflection. But I worry if this prelude is giving the right impression or not. You see, I want to make you feel something. I want you to feel hope. I want you to know that I have a plan for our society that is sprinting down a winding slope. I want you to know that I love you. And I want you to know that when I am incapable, my God will still be available, because for me, he has been unbreakable. My quiet rock in the sea that is this world. Whenever I speak a word, I feel as if he's listening, and I feel as if I'm heard. I mentioned before all the pain I've been through, but in reality, it wasn't more than a strain of bad times, yet they left a stain. Crimes of a nightmare still imprinted in my mind. There's no need to read between the lines. Self-love was non-existent. I was coexisting with things like depression and anxiety. Quickened heartbeats slowly and quietly sinking deeper into this mental rivalry. I became a scorekeeper. Sydney 0, depression 1. Sydney 0, depression 2. Sydney 1, no scratch that 0. Depression 3. My focus was feathery. Anxiety always had its finger on the command key. And then the day came when I became so exhausted of exhaustion that I imported some assistance. It takes persistence and more than passive resistance, but more importantly, it takes more than just willpower. For me, it took a savior. It took who the Christians believed to be the creator. For me, it took failure. It took handing my control over, handing over my heart and my soul to my Lord and interior decorator. He decks out my brain with new wisdom. I pray that this mind of mine becomes his kingdom. This isn't just symbolism. I pray that my God would fill every inch of me, and that he would work his way into my digestive system, so that I might digest new information with a bigger view, so that I might view what I see through a filter of love and understanding, for he has blessed me with waves of self-love and the discovery of meditation, which allows me to daily form a mental connection with he who is my maker, slayer of the demons that once made my voice quaver. No longer am I their slave, and I need not embrace mental illness, for with my God I have mental fitness. I'm able to give myself forgiveness, forgiveness for the maliciousness I once embraced, forgiveness for the view I held of myself, vision that was laced with self-hate. But that distaste has been erased, because I have the ability to view myself through the eyes of my Creator. Hatred was replaced with appreciation of my body's ability to be strong, and then over a multitude of days, I noticed that appreciation was replaced with a certain mentation of love, looking in the mirror and saying, I'm hot as fudge. The world may not always agree, but I don't know if they've seen the inside of me. Trust me when I say I have plenty of room to grow in niceness, kindness, and politeness. But hey, I'm not above handing myself a compliment. So Sydney, I'm proud of your accomplishments, and I think your internal hard work needs acknowledgement. Your growth in love, wisdom, and joy, I understand that they were not drop shipments, but goals reached in self-hate impeached. So hold your head high. You need not further beautify yourself, because dang, girl, you a bombshell. So